Hello, how are you? As always, we will tell you different applications and functionalities to be able to use Arduino in industrial environments. In this case, we are going to show you a post that we have made to teach you how to convert a signal 420 mA to 0.10 volts for analog inputs. We will also explain how these analog inputs are programmed with Arduino IDE. First of all, I wanted to tell you what a 420 mA signal is and why this type of input is a standard. A 420 mA signal is an analog signal that, if connected to an Arduino board or an industrial PLC, it allows you to read the sensor value. The controller receives a signal from the sensor through a current signal, which lets it to transform this electrical signal to an interpretable value ready to be programmed and understandable for the code developed. This value is used by the programmer to know the units of measurement received by the sensor and understand in what state the developed industrial project is. 420 mA signals are mainly used for wiring over long distances, because the current signal transmission receives less electrical noise and less EMC interference, just the opposite that do receive a voltage signal as is 0.10 volts. An Arduino board cannot receive an analog signal by current, because the analog signals in the Arduino are from 0 to 5 volts, so it is necessary to transform the current to a voltage signal. It is important to know that in the industry, analog voltage signals work from 0 to 10 volts, so the way to transform a 420 mA signal is somewhat different in an Arduino-based PLC than on an Arduino board. Now, we are going to tell you an industrial application with Arduino for reading analog signals. It is necessary to convert that signal 420 mA to 0.10 volts. Now, let me show you the diagram below, where you can define that the conversion of the signal is done by the Ohm's law. At the end, what you have is a resistance, as you can see in the scheme, which value in this case is 500 ohms. And the reason why it transforms the signal 420 mA is because if you multiply 20 mA by 500 ohms, the signal is transformed to 10 volts. When you work at 4 mA, in this case, instead of having a 0 volts, you have 2 volts. So here, at this point, you have a change of scale that you have to consider in the code. The entire family of products we have, both ARDBOX and Ethernet PLC, have several configurable analog signals that allow us to read this type of sensors. To do this, it is necessary to connect the resistance of 500 ohms between the analog 420 mA signal to the GND as shown in the draw. Now, how can you program a 420 mA signal in an Arduino device? First of all, you need an Arduino-based PLC or an Arduino board. Then it is necessary a signal converter. In this case, the signal converter is a DIN rail terminal that incorporates the resistance of 500 ohms to do what we have explained before, to confirm the Ohm's law and transform the signal from 420 mA to 0.10 volts. The same happens modifying the value of the resistor from 500 to 250. So the final voltage will be 5 volts, ready to be read by the Arduino board. And finally, the Arduino IDE. On this platform, you will be able to open an example, as is the analog input example. And you will see how an original 10 bits Arduino input is read with a value between 0 and 1023. If you haven't used the Arduino IDE before, or you are not comfortable with it, you can also subscribe to a free course we offer, so you can see from basics how to use Arduino in industrial environments. Now, I recommend you to continue reading the post to know more about how to transform a signal 420 mA to 0.10 volts or to 0.5 volts, if you want to connect it directly with an Arduino board. If you are viewing this message from YouTube, you can link on the post at the comments below. I will also ask you to subscribe to our channel so that you can be informed of all our updates that we are making and new posts that we upload from our blog. We already have over 200 posts with high level and interesting contents to know how to use Arduino in industrial environments.